and everything was good. And everything was good. And everything was good. And everything was good. Everything was good. Man then lived like gods, without subtle heart. And everything was good. Remote and free from toil and grief, man then lived. Everything was good. Without sorrow of heart. Everything was good. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden. Pai-ri-dai-za, paradise, the enclosure. We live in such a state of protection that in general we can go weeks, months, even years without having to be in fear and flee from a real and present threat. Pai Ri Dai Za, paradise, the enclosure. Today, a discourse of infiltration or infection prevails. The threat no longer comes from above, but from the outside, whether it be in the form of bacteria, harmful rays of foreigners. Paradise is a garden-like ontological model of the world. The first man who, having fenced in a piece of land, said, "This is mine," and found people naive enough to believe him, was the true founder of bourgeois society. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, paradise, the enclosure. The garden is a place of yearning for continuity. At the very moment he wishes the garden to remain as it is, it then begins its decline. Remain as it is. Continuity. Giant hogweed not only displaces other plants, it is also harmful to humans and animals. Today, a discourse of infiltration or infection prevails. Gardens are pictures. One often forgets this because they are represented on a scale of 1 to 1. Free from toil and grief, without sorrow of heart, and everything was good. Depicted as a heron, the luminous bird was a manifestation of the sun god of creation who introduced the first light into the darkness of chaos. As it came to rest upon the primeval hill, it emitted a cry. This was the first sound.
Ah.